Hello students, welcome back to your English literature class. In our previous session, you had done the explanation of first stanza of the poem Dover Beach. Today, we shall continue with the explanation of next two stanzas. By the end of this video, you will be able to explain meaning of difficult words as used in the context of the poem. Explain stanza 2 and stanza 3 in your own words. Identify and understand literary devices used in stanza 2 and stanza 3. Before we begin with the explanation, I would suggest you to read your poem again and again so that you can memorize it and during your exams you can quote lines from it. Let's begin with the discussion of word meanings of stanza 2. Sophocles. As I've already told you, Sophocles was one of the most famous writers of tragic play in ancient Greece, and his surviving works written throughout the 5th century BCE include such classics as Oedipus the King, Antigone, and Women of Trachis. Aegean. Aegean Sea is the sea that separates Greece from Turkey. Turbid. It means cloudy, muddy, or confused. Ebb and flow. The high and the low tide. Misery. Wretchedness. Now, let's read stanza 2. Sophocles long ago heard it on the Aegean, and it brought into his mind the turbid ebb and flow of human misery. We find also in the sound a thought, hearing it by the distant northern sea. In the previous stanza, we were told that the speaker called out to his beloved to come to the window and listen to the harsh sound of the pebbles as they struck against the shore, and the rise and fall of the waves in a set pattern produced a slow trembling kind of music which brought in a note of melancholy which was everlasting. In these lines, the speaker alludes to the Greek tragedy writer Sophocles, who heard the eternal note of sadness when he sat beside the Aegean Sea, which brought to his mind the turbid ebb and flow of human misery, that is, the endless suffering of man. The speaker, like Sophocles, observes the sea, and he also finds a message in its motion. He compares the human misery to the constant motion of the sea. Like Sophocles, the speaker is also reminded of eternal human misery as they hear to the slow sound of this northern sea water. Let us discuss the literary device used in this stanza. I have already told you allusion. It is a reference to other works or cultures in either prose or poetry. Writers often allude to mythology, religious stories, or other works of literature from the past. In the poem, Matthew Arnold has alluded to the ancient Greek playwright Sophocles to offer a context for the speaker's growing sadness in the poem. What does it mean? Just like the sound of Aegean Sea reminded Sophocles of the human misery, in the same way, the speaker also listens to the slow motion of the northern sea water that reminds him of the eternal human misery. Now, let's proceed to stanza 3. The sea of faith. Now here students, we have a metaphor for faith. What is metaphor? Metaphor is a figure of speech in which a comparison between two different things is implied but not clearly stated. Just like in simile, we have the words like as and like. But here, we do not make use of such words. The comparison is not directly given, it is implied. So the sea of faith is metaphor for the faith in spirituality, God and religion. Girdle, something that wraps or circles around something else. For example, a belt. Melancholy, a sad mood or feeling. Withdrawing, retracting or going back. Retreating, the process of receding from a position or state attained. Again, it means going back. Shingles, a mass of small rounded pebbles, especially on a seashore. Now, let's read the stanza. The sea of faith was once two at the full, and round earth's shore lay like the folds of a bright girdle furled. Now I only hear its melancholy, long withdrawing roar, retreating to the breath of the night wind, down the vast edges drear and naked shingles of the world. The speaker says, just as the sea is full right now, once upon a time, the world was full of faith. So, sea here becomes a symbol of faith, and so we have metaphor, where faith has been compared to sea without using the words as or like. Once this sea of faith had encircled the whole world, just like the girdle or belt. In these lines, if you observe, Matthew Arnold has made use of simile. What is simile? It is a figure of speech in which likeness between two things is explicitly stated using the words as or like. So here the word like has been used. Arnold states that spiritual faith was once all round the earth's shore like the folds of a bright girdle fold. So spiritual faith has been compared here to a belt. Now the sea is fast retreating. It's going back. That means the faith is becoming less, leaving behind bare and naked shingles. As the wind of the night begins to blow, the harsh reality, which is symbolized by naked and dreary pebbles on seashore. This harsh reality leaves mankind sad and dejected. The poet refers to the idea of world being covered in naked shingles. It means that when faith pulls away, it leaves nothing behind but sadness. Another literary device used here is assonance. It is a use of words that have very similar vowel sounds near one another. So here we have its melancholy, long withdrawing roar. So which sound do we have here? It's melancholy with ing. So we have the sound of e. It's melancholy, long withdrawing roar. So the literary device used here is assonance. Students, I hope you have understood today's lesson. Your homework for today is to plan explanation of stanza 4 with the help of your workbook.